Hello everybody, I'm Steven Snake Youkin Lindsay of GamerzStation here, and this is Browser Games of the Week for the week of May 8th. Now as a note to any of you that might be new to our videos, what we're going to be doing is telling you about some of the better browser games for this week. Now as a note, some of these games may have actually came out in previous weeks, but as we often go by Newgrounds standards of date, because they actually have the dates up, that's what we go by for the most part, unless we find it on a different site on an earlier date, like we did with Everybody's Plumbers. It's 2 weeks back that we found it! Also, as another note, these games are in no particular order of how good they are or how awful they are. They're just in the order that we happen to find them. And as a final note, if you happen to come across a game that came out this week that we didn't put on the list, simply leave a comment with the name and a link to the game and share it with everybody else. Now, time to start the list. Considering that there's an oil spill in the Gulf of Mexico, there's no surprise that someone would come up with a game involving oil. Granted, Oilworm isn't about the spill, but we can easily make the comparison. Actually, we can't, but just go with me. The game is a simple collect stars and don't touch the fire and lava game. But as the game goes on, timing becomes more and more important. And also, there becomes ghosts! I guess they died in the lava! It's not the longest or most challenging game out there, but it's short and fun to play, and you can probably finish it in your lunch break or something. Most people hate bugs, especially when they're in your home. But what about bugs fighting each other? Well, obviously that's alright, as long as they're not in my home. The game doesn't involve much strategy. All you need to do is send bugs from one point to another, either a neutral location to conquer it, or the enemy's base to kill them all. Along with that, you get magical spells to use if you kill enough troops. Oh, sailing, sailing, sailing on the Royal Navy ship. An educational game, yes, even educational games can be fun, which takes place during the time of Napoleon Bonaparte, not dynamite. The game takes place on a historical nautical battle during the Napoleonic Wars, but if you're like me, you probably don't know the historical context at all, and you probably could care less. All that matters is you control a boat that can destroy other boats. I believe I've mentioned prior that several games are coming out in the vein of Kitten Launcher and Turtle Toss, and it's becoming more and more popular. Well, guess what? We have a new game that's very similar to those! But this one has some explanation on why we're launching the thing. So imagine, if you will, that you're being chased by a bear that can walk on its two back legs. And you come across a catapult. Your first thought should be that I'm going to launch myself on that catapult as far as I can to get away from the bear. Well, too bad the bear can always catch up with you and likes to pretend it's Dr. Robotnik from time to time. Paper clips. The clippers of papers. What could be more interesting than physics involving paper clips? Actually, I can think of several. The goal of the game is simple. Knock down a set number of paper clips with a ball made of paper clips. Simple, easy, and it can be fun in short bursts. Another great game in the installment of reincarnation games, even if it's not as long as the first two. So a hillbilly has been reincarnated via the reincarnation portals, and it's up to you to see if you can have anything against him so that you can send him back to hell. We all know that in these games, someone is always going to be going to hell. So you're the son of Lucifer, but your old man has been removed from the throne for some time by another demonic being. What do? You take the throne yourself, obviously. Well, too bad you're no match for the new devil and get thrown out of hell. Now you have to go back to get your horns, wings, tails, before you can go back to face the new devil. In the year 2030, because of the rapid increase in the human population, food supplies are extremely low, and several humans have resorted to cannibalism. However, the smart people have gone underground to create a new source of food. Your job is to control the reaction involved with this process and to prevent the test tubes from exploding! This mainly comes down to turning all the brightly colored cells in a row red. Yes, turning them red. Very few games involve you playing as the bad guy and you not knowing it. That's what Cursed Treasure is about. You play as the evil overlord trying to protect his, her gems from the heroes. Darn those heroes. Time for a tower defense game involving the gems. You probably know the drill by now. Kill invading waves, get money experience through this, and use those to upgrade and buy new defenses. Well, as you're not a robot, you don't have to worry, right? Well, you control a robot, so it's close enough. Travel through 60 different psychedelic levels of challenging puzzles and platforming. Use your grappling hook to get through these challenges that just become more and more challenging to survive with each one you complete, and it makes you possibly want to give up. Robots. The long-awaited sequel that many probably didn't think would happen. Chaos Faction 2 hasn't changed all that much from the original. The point of the game is similar to Super Smash Bros. Defeat whoever lies in front of you to progress the game. With each new level you beat, the more characters and weapons you get. Also, you can customize the look of your character like you could in the original, but with more details than you could last time! If you're like me, when you hear the phrase Paradoxian Express, you're probably expecting a game involving paradoxes. Well, too bad! It's not that game! It's a puzzle game, baby, involving balls. Clear the board by matching up three balls of the same color, but it's never as easy as clicking and dragging them to the board. And with that, this week's Browser Games of the Week list comes to an end. Now, as a reminder, we will be putting up these videos each and every week, probably on a Saturday, maybe a Sunday on some rare occasions. So if you always want to be up to date on the new browser games that have came out in the week, simply subscribe to us and make sure you watch the new videos that we put up on Saturday or Sunday. Also, you might enjoy some of our reviews that we occasionally put up whenever we have free time. So, till then, enjoy the credits. They're not that good.